If you're working on a big project and want to improve your in-editor performance by lowering your compile times and also organize your project, there's a quick and easy way to force yourself to do it. Today, we're diving into assembly definitions. Welcome to 100 Tips in Unity series, and this is episode number 2. So I have been working on a dialogue system here for you guys. It's going to be completely free and I will release it soon, so make sure to stick around for that. Now, whenever we go to one of these scripts, let's say we go to the dialogue manager, and then we make some changes, Unity is going to take some time to recompile our code. So whenever you make changes to one of these scripts, all of the other scripts in Unity gets recompiled. Now, this is just a dialogue system. Assuming you have a bunch of other code in your game, maybe third-party plugins and stuff, everything will get recompiled, which is not ideal. By using something called assembly definitions, we can control how compilation works. And it's very easy to do. We can create an assembly definition by right-clicking, create, scripting, assembly definition. So in this example, I'm going to give it dialogue system. We just need to place them in this folder, and all of the scripts in this folder, along with the scripts in the subfolders, will be a part of this new assembly. Assembly in Unity, or in generally C#, is sort of like a compiled collection of code. That is the simplest way to put it. They are typically stored in a .dll file, and they include scripts and all of their associated code, which Unity compiles as a single unit. Assembly definitions are simply files in Unity that allows us to define our own custom assemblies. And it gives us finer control on how different parts of our code gets compiled. Now, whenever you create an assembly definition, chances are that you will get errors in your console. This is because all of these scripts are a part of a separate assembly, and they no longer contain access to the typical Unity stuff. So in this example, you can see that the namespace, TextMesh Pro, input system, Cinemachine, game events, all of these things are not a part of this thing. So how do we fix these errors? Whenever you see errors, all you gotta do is click on this assembly and make sure to add some references to other assemblies that Unity has already made for us. So we can go to the console. First up is TextMesh Pro. So we add a reference, click on it, search TextMesh Pro, and then you can find unity.textmeshpro. So input system, Cinemachine, and there we go. And these are all of the Unity related assemblies. We can hit apply, and the errors are not gone still. This happens sometimes. And the way you fix that is by right clicking on this and then hit re-import. This is going to force Unity to re-import this assembly. And you can see the errors are gone, but there are errors related to game event, which is a custom script that I have made. How do we fix this? Because we have created one assembly definition, we are now forced to create other assembly definitions for the rest of our scripts. But it's a very quick and easy fix. In this example, I have a game events folder. This one needs an assembly definition as well. So we right click, create, scripting, assembly definition, and we call it game events. And now you'll get even more errors. It's again, input system, TextMesh Pro. These are the errors. So we just simply add new references and we are good to go. So now we just go back to the dialog system and then add a reference to this new game events assembly definition that we have made, and we hit apply. Once again, this is annoying. We just hit re-import if Unity doesn't update. And now all of the errors are gone. And now if we make a change to one of these scripts and go back, the compile times are much more faster, because earlier we could see that green bar, now it is not even there. It's just super fast. So whenever you're creating a third-party plugin or creating a system, or even coding in general, get into the habit of creating assembly definitions first. So that is the tip. Now, just to show you, inside this game events, there's an example folder which contains UI manager. And UI manager should not be a part of game events. So how do we separate that? To do that, we can either create a new assembly definition here, or we can create an assembly definition reference. So just to show you an example of how references work, on my scripts folder, I'm going to create a new assembly definition. Let me call this player core. Here I can create, instead of an assembly definition, you create an assembly definition reference. And let's call this player core ref. And then you choose the assembly definition that you want to reference here, and you hit apply. And now if you re-import again, you'll get new errors. This is because the new assembly definition that we have made needs to reference, again, Text Mesh Pro, and then finally, input system. And you're good to go. Again, re-import. Now, just to show you how editor scripts work, you can create another assembly definition here. Let me call it dialogue_system.editor. And it needs to have a reference to the dialogue system. And we can deselect all of these platforms and then choose only editor. This means that these scripts will only be compiled for the editor, and hit apply. So you could have code just for Android, you could have code just for iOS, and assembly definitions make it easier to manage them. Okay. Furthermore, you can define constraints and version defines. These are like preprocessor directives and scripting symbols that you can add furthermore to add more control over how assembly definitions work. You can read more about it from the link in the description. Okay, but these are the general things. You just create an assembly definition, you specify the references, and then you choose the platforms. You can also specify a root namespace for our assemblies as well. Okay, now there's one thing that you need to understand. Assuming you have an assembly A, and then you have an assembly B, you have an assembly C, and then you have an assembly D, and then you have Unity. Okay, assembly D has a reference to Unity. So it goes up from Unity, okay? And both B and C contains a reference to D. And A contains a reference to B, and A contains a reference to C. Now, A is at the top. If we make a change in A, nothing else is recompiled, okay? A is the one that has all the references. And nothing is referencing A. So, assuming this is our latest scripts, we no longer need to compile B, C, D, and Unity related stuff. If B was the one to be compiled, both A and B will be compiled. C has nothing to do with B. So, C will not be compiled, and B has a reference to D. References are not compiled. So, D is also not compiled. Unity is also not compiled, which means when we make changes to any of the scripts in the assembly B, only A gets recompiled, which is important to understand. If we were to make changes to D, because all of these are referencing D, all of these will be recompiled. Okay, so this is what assembly definitions does. But more often than not, we don't have to recompile D. Most of the time we are working on top level. For example, this could be the input system. This could be, let's say, player controller, and this could be player movement or something like that. And because each of these references one another, once we're done with the controller, we don't usually come back to it unless we need to add another input, right? The same goes with the input system. We don't even touch it at all. But we might have to come back to movement. So if we were to make changes to movement, now our player controller and the input system is no longer compiled, which is a great advantage. Okay, so you're saving time whenever you make changes to A. You're not saving time a lot when you make changes to D, but when you're making changes to A, which is what you will do most of the time, you are saving a lot of time. If you didn't have assembly definitions and if you made changes to A, A, B, C, D, and Unity stuff will be recompiled. So if you use assembly definitions and make changes to A, only A will be recompiled, which is a huge deal. So I hope you get the idea of what exactly is happening under the hood. I hope this video was useful. Let me know what you think. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one where we talk about canvases. We're going to be completely trying our best to optimize canvases in Unity for your final games. Take care. I'll see you in the next one.